This illustration is about a motorboat in a lake. Here we are given that a motorboat of mass M moves in a lake with velocity V0. At t equal to 0, the engine of boat is switched off and the water resistance is proportional to speed of boat and it varies as Fr is minus Rv, where R is a constant. And we are required to find the time for which boat will move before coming to rest. And also we are required to find the average velocity of boat during the interval its velocity changes from V0 to V0 by 2. So here, first we can directly write that the acceleration of boat can be written as A is equals to minus R by M multiplied by V. Because in this situation, we are given that resistance force is minus Rv. So, in this situation, we can write A as dV by dt. So, dV by dt is minus R by M times V, which can be written as dV by V is equals to minus R by M dt. So, if we integrate this term at t equals to 0, the speed was V0 at an time t, the speed changes to v. So, left hand side becomes ln of v and substituting limits, this will be ln of v by v0 is equals to minus rt by m. On simplifying, this will give us the speed as v0 e to power minus rt by m. So, here we can see the value of v is equals to 0 when here t is tending to infinity. When this t tends to infinity, then only the speed becomes 0. And here we are required to find the time for which boat will move before coming to rest. So, v equal to 0, which signifies rest. So, boat will come to rest only when t tending to infinity or after a very, very long time. This will be the result of the first part of the problem. And here we are also required to find the average velocity of boat during time interval, its velocity changes from V0 to V0 by 2. So, if we continue here, we can write at t equals to 0, the value of speed was V0. And we can write at t is equals to T1 if speed changes to V0 by 2. And using this expression, we can find out the time T1. So, if we write this as equation 1, then we can write from 1, we can substitute V as V0 by 2. So, this V0 by 2 is equals to V0 e to power minus RT by M. And the value of T we can put as T1. So, in this situation, this V0 gets cancelled out and on left hand side, it can be written as ln 2 is equals to RT1 by M. This implies the value of time after which the speed reduces to V0 by 2 is M by R ln 2. So now we can directly calculate the average velocity by the average function which is given as 1 by T1 integration from 0 to T1. This V as a function of time dt. On substituting the value, this 1 by t1 integration 0 to t1 and v as a function of time is v0 e to power minus rt by m dt. So, if we integrate this term, the average velocity here can be given as, on integrating this term, it is v0 by t1 and if we integrate e to power minus rt by m, this will be v0 m by rt1. And its integration remains same. This is minus e to power minus rt by m and limits from 0 to t1. So, if we substitute the value of t1, it is m by r ln 2. So, the left hand side here it becomes v0 by ln 2. And this term, if we substitute t1, this will become minus e to power minus r by m t1, which can be written as minus ln 2. If we substitute 0, this will become plus 1. So, we can write it 1 minus e to power minus ln 2. And this can be further written as e to power minus ln 2 can be written as 1 by 2. So, the result is V0 by 2 ln 2. That will be the final result of the problem.